Hola chicos, ahora empezamos con el capítulo 8. Capítulo 8. Normalmente hago el video del capítulo casi al final del capítulo previo, pero esta vez estoy haciendo el video más temprano. Porque no estoy en el país durante de la semana de capítulo 7. Okay, chapter 8. Normally, like I said, I make these videos as we're getting towards the end of the previous chapter. That way I can comment on some of the work that's been done. This time, though, I'm making the video early simply because I will be out of the country during the time period of capítulo 7. And I'm not going to attempt making the video while I'm in the Dominican Republic. I will, like I said, jump online probably once a day and I'll check to see if there's questions in the forum. I'll check my email. I'll jump really quick on Skype to see if you've left me chat messages there. But in general, it's going to be more scattered access to the internet for me. So just be aware of that. So I'm making this video a little early to talk about what we're going to be doing in capítulo 8. So capítulo 8 is ¿En qué puedo servirle? How can I help you? So vocabulary will be based on things such as shopping, being in stores. You'll learn more vocabulary for clothing. We've already had bits and pieces of that throughout previous chapters, especially if you started with capítulo 1, talking about personal products. So it's really useful vocabulary for everyday life in a Spanish-speaking country because you do things like go shopping in your everyday life. Grammar-wise, we will be continuing with the past tense in Spanish. We'll be learning the other past tense that is used, which is the imperfect. And the imperfect is a way of speaking about past actions that had a more general time frame, that were longer lasting in the past. For example, you could say, when I was 5 years old, I learned to read. It's not an exact date, it's not an exact time period, so you're talking about a time period with a longer time frame, a longer idea. It's also used for descriptions in the past, for talking about age in the past. So we'll be learning the imperfect tense, and then part of capítulo 8 is learning how to distinguish when you use the preterite and when you use the imperfect. Other grammar points in this chapter, you will be learning ordinal numbers. So, for example, we say first, second, third, fourth, etc. And in Spanish, they do that as well. That's an extremely easy concept, and it's interesting because generally in Spanish, they don't use ordinal numbers beyond 10th. So, it's something that's pretty quick and simple to get. And then we'll be looking at impersonal constructions with using se. Now, impersonal constructions using se are like using passive voice in English or using instructions that are generalized in English. So, for example, se vende la casa, which literally translates into house for sale. Or someone is selling this house, but we don't know who exactly is doing it, so that's why we use se vende. Okay, and you'll see more of that in the chapter. I will do a brief recorded lecture for you on that as well. Culturally, we're going to be looking now into South America, starting with the Incan region of Peru and Ecuador. Work-wise, very similar to what you've already had. You have your Michelle Tomas, and you will do a quiz again. If you can't record in the actual quiz under tests and surveys, please make a recording file and submit it in assignments. You will have Duolingo. You will submit your first Duolingo screenshot with this chapter. So work, please, to get to where we are with our course materials. You have your film, and you're going to post in the forums and respond to another student. You have your form composition post, same thing. You will make your own post. Remember, at least three sentences and respond to another student with that as well. Those must be done in Spanish, remember. So you might want to think about typing them first in Microsoft Word with the International Spanish Spell Check on, just so that you're writing pretty accurately. We're getting to the point where you shouldn't be doing things like leaving out accents, or if you're making an exclamatory remark, you should make sure you have the explanation in front and behind, the same with questions. So start making sure you're working on those little things that make writing in Spanish distinctive. Additionally, of course, you have your e-text you need to go through, and you have your My Spanish Lab homework. And finally, as a part of Capítulo 8, you have your first exam. And I know this seems quick, but each exam is only over two chapters. So you do have an exam every 2 weeks in this class. So please be aware of that. Do all of your work for the chapter first and then take the exam. So you want to make sure you've completed everything, that you're comfortable with the materials before you move forward. Don't forget about SI. You do SI with every chapter. It's a required part for your participation. You will want to get with Sarah for conversation hours. Again, this is a required part of your grade in this course. And with Capítulo 9, you will be doing your first oral exam. So it's good to be out there practicing with her in conversation hours. I may have left something off. I don't always have everything clear and written in a list in my head. So the other most important thing is to go through every single section of the module. If you go through all those sections of the module, you will be certain that you have not missed any of the required work for the chapter. Any questions, you can post in the forums if it's of a general nature. Email me if it's not. After July the 16th, when I return to the country, you can also text me with questions. My requirements or guidelines for texting are on our syllabus. So just be aware, please don't text me during the middle of the night. That's not generally appreciated, and I wouldn't respond before the next morning anyway. So let's get going with Chapter 8. Anything comes up, you know where to find us. Y buena suerte. Adios.